Good evening. Evening, PA. Adriana Sandino. Okay, then. Good evening. And by the way, I was graduating fall 2021, not fall 2020. I don't see where you have that on my application board.
No.
I don't know if you guys can hear me. Yeah, you should be able to hear me.
No, we can't hear you. I'm sorry.
Hello, friends.
Probably can't hear my music, though. That's fine.
For more people to join, so stay tuned. Hello, everybody. How are you guys?
Hello.
Hello.
Okay, cool. Awesome. How is everyone? How is finals?
Finally done.
Finally, yeah. Actually.
Let's not talk about that.
Awesome. Yeah. I have a paper due tomorrow, so yeah. okay, so
I'm done with finals. So
cool, awesome. Okay, so I'm gonna start our fall ceremony for fall 2020. This is our second online induction ceremony. So, yay! so yeah, let's get started. So for agenda today, we're gonna be talking about our chapter presentation. More about our executive board and our committee members, and then we'll go to the induction ceremony, what everyone is here for, and then also, and then after that, we'll go to awards, and we'll be just announcing like outstanding general members, outstanding e-board members, and etc. And after that, we're gonna go to closing remarks, and yeah, and feel free to stay after to hang out and chat. Okay, so chapter presentation. So what have we as a UP accomplished this year? First, what is UP? As everyone here knows what UP is, we are FIU's tech community made by students for students interested in tech. So we have over 700 active members, 9 programs, and we're recognized locally and nationally. And we're supported by a bunch of companies and sponsored by them, and we're supported by CEC and SEIS. So this is a picture of us back then before Corona was a thing. But yeah, as you can see, we have a large community. And I basically, our mission is to foster a community that empowers students to succeed in the world of technology. And here are some of our sponsors. As you can see, there's a bunch of sponsors, like Microsoft, Google, Facebook, Amazon, and more. And then here are some of our achievements. So we actually got our fourth time for a standing chapter for UP Nationals. And we got a standing engineering organization from FIU Council for Student Organizations, outstanding service from FIU Student Affairs and SCIS and CSO. And here are some of our more achievements. Some of our members of UP, what we received. So Caesar, Christopher, and Shauna, they're all part of our eBoard members, executive board. And they all received a sailing service from FIU SCIS. Also Shayla, Elmi, Gatika, Chuhan, Adolfo Jimenez, Jessica Hernandez, and Carolina. And they received all these awards. And some of, here's our World Ahead graduate members. Most of them have been really involved with UPE, or some of them are a part of our executive board, were a part of our executive board. So yeah. This year, these are some of our scholarships that some of our members have received. So for Grace Hopper, these are some of the members who received Grace Hopper scholarships. So Danae, Tate, Hoy and Yasmin, as well as our current president receiving the Executive Council Award from UPE. And then we also have one of our other executive members receiving the UPE Scholarship Award. So yeah, membership is free for all FIU students. You're free to join. And this is just a recap of what happened this past fall semester. So we had a fall kickoff week where we basically just started the semester, explaining what our next workshops are, and just to get the semester started. And then we had our second general meeting talking about more of our workshops and our upcoming events. And then game night, where we all went on Discord and played Among Us, which is super fun. And we recently just had our final general meeting last week on Friday, talking about more about induction, which is right now. So, like where we played Among Us, we all play that on one Discord server, and we have a huge virtual community. So feel free to join if you're not already part of our Discord. And yes, here is us on our game night, I believe. We're playing Among Us or one of our general meetings. But yeah, as you see, there's a lot of members who are being active and joining our events. And then we have Hashing with UP. This is our podcast, our own podcast hosted by our executive board. We always get guest speakers to speak about different topics. So our first episode was searching for a job during the pandemic. And we had I was one of the guest speakers. And we also had Caesar and Chris, which are our previous presidents. And then the second episode was more about technical development, where we had other guest speakers talked about their experience at the technical side. So feel free to listen to us on Spotify. Just look up Hashing with UP, and we should be the first one to be there. And then now I'm gonna get our program directors to speak about their programs. And first we have Dewan. You're here.
Hey everyone, before I talk about code, I do want to talk about that. There is a third episode of Passion with UP that just dropped on Monday. It's available on all your podcast services that you use. So yeah, for code, I'm Dewan Harris. I'm the current director of code. And you can move on to the next slide. So what is code? It's a program that teaches you how to build software using all sorts of tools and technologies. This semester, we focused a lot on web development and mobile development, but in other semesters, we featured game development and AI and data science and stuff like that. So that's one of the big reasons that people participate in code, and so they can learn a lot more about software engineering. This semester, if you go to the next slide, you'll see some of the events that we had. We had two web development workshops. The first one was more into HTML, CSS, and Git. The second one was about JavaScript. We also had a workshop on building your first API with Node.js. And our last workshop was building a mobile application with React Native. That's good.
So now we have UP Make, which is Charles. If you come up to the stage, please.
Hey guys, my name is Charles. I'm the director of UP Make currently, but definitely next semester we are going to have a new director. So keep out for that. It's going to be a lot of new stuff that we're going to be bringing. I'm still going to be there helping out. But yeah, some of the stuff that we do for UP Make, it's based mostly around programming embedded systems or embedded devices. So like things like 3D Arduinos, Raspberry Pis. We also handle 3D modeling and 3D printing. So that's things like using Fusion 360. We also use Thinkercad, which is a simulator which we use to program on an Arduino since we were virtual. If you go to the next slide, you'll see some of the workshops that we had this semester. Yeah, so as you can see, we did an Arduino workshop where we used Thinkercad. So Thinkercad allowed us to do all this stuff virtually because better to do something virtually, but hopefully next semester, whenever we're able to, we'll start doing things in person. It'll be a lot more interactive. We also did a Fusion 360 workshop. We showed you how to use simulations and that type of stuff. And then for the Raspberry Pi, we programmed an LED strip to do different sequences of lights. So if you're interested in that, make sure to keep up with us next semester for sure. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Charles. Now we have Nathan for InfoTech.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm the director of the InfoTech program, Nathan Pabon, currently at UPE. So a little bit about what we do. So essentially, our goal is to train you guys in skills in IT and like cybersecurity, because I know there's like a huge gap in that, at least in terms of like computer science students. It's like focused towards software, but in reality, in the workplace, you're expected to know other things than what you're just taught in university. So that's what we intend to do essentially. And especially for those who are interested in these particular topics as well. So in terms of like cybersecurity concepts, we sometimes go over like malware analysis, pen testing, and other security concepts. We in terms of DevOps, we do like things like Docker or like Google Cloud or AWS. And for like general IT stuff, we also go into like networking and Linux concepts as well. So here I will show you the events that we had this semester. So we covered Linux, we covered IT automation with Ansible, we've covered malware analysis using a variety of tools, and we've also covered a very popular containerization software called Docker. So look out for more events that we have next semester, and I will leave you to the director of UPE Advance.
Hi, everyone. It's Gabby, the UP Advanced Director. Unfortunately, this is my last semester, but somebody will be taking my place next semester. Next slide. Okay, so what is Advanced? Pretty much we're focused on professional development. We do that with, you know, technical interview prep, behavioral interview workshops, resume reviews, company info sessions, and intern panels. And this semester, we kind of tried something new with the technical interview prep because last semester was kind of crazy. So we tried doing this thing called LeetCode. So we did LeetCode prep, and next semester it's going to be a little bit more refined, and we're going to have a little bit more of that and more workshops for technical interview prep because it's very important, very needed. Next slide, please. So through Advance, we've had a lot of UPE members get jobs or internships in really top tech companies. Next slide. So, you know, for example, like Amazon, Microsoft, you know, all those companies. So here are some of the events that we've had. We've had a lot of companies come to, well, in this case, it's like Zoom, like Google, they hosted like a Build Your Brand for resume. And then we had a Splunk info session, Intuit info session. We had Conquering Behavioral interview and an intern panel. Thank you.
So now we have UP Ignite, which will be Diana.
Hi, everyone. My name is Diana Barrero, and I am the director of UP Ignite. UP Ignite is a community outreach program where we teach the basics of computer science to students within the Miami-Dade County Public Schools community. Our volunteers do receive a lot of benefits from this program, such as volunteer hours, leadership. We gain leadership and we learn how to teach at schools. And then next semester, we're coming back with something extra special, which is that now the program is going to be a CS teaching internship for the FIU, for FIU. So we're going to actually have a class within FIU. Some of the past events that we've, these are some of the pictures from the school meetings that we've had with the students this past semester, where we got to teach them a little bit on Scratch. And then I'll hand it over to Joseph.
Hello, everyone. Good evening. My name is Joseph Abdul, and I'm the director of SparkDev. First of all, before I begin, I want to congratulate everybody who's getting inducted tonight. It's a big achievement, as well as every student, because we just finished finals. It's not easy, but we made it. We made it. And yeah, looking forward to a great spring 2021 semester with SparkDev. So what is a SparkDev? Well, what we like to do is that we build STEM projects during a 9-week period to learn about a particular interest or passion. We create projects in a risk-free environment, meaning that your GPA, your curriculum, your career, anything won't be affected by what you create, because we think this should be a rewarding experience rather than something that could affect you in a bad way. We also utilize the latest tools in the industry to create these projects. And we, one of the purpose of SparkDev as well is to network with like-minded individuals to strengthen your resumes and be more competitive in the workforce. Next slide, please. So for this semester, we had 10 different teams. We had the artificial intelligence, game development, mobile development, web development, also robotics, virtual reality. We had for the first semester, our public health technology team, also our sponsored team by the FIU IT department, our information technology team, and finally our two teams that are part with for a partnership with Microsoft and nonprofit organizations in order to improve the South Florida communities through technology. So these teams were the Underline with Friends of the Underline and also Dreaming Green with the Dreaming Green organization. So for this semester, we had our SparkDev orientation. We also had a game night to de-stress a little bit during mid-semester and play a little bit of Among Us and other games. And finally, we had Demo Day, an amazing project where the teams got to demo it, their projects that they developed during the 9 weeks to the whole FIU community, as well as our partners. Next slide. And finally, before I hand it over, I just want to say that if you are looking forward to being a team lead for next semester, be on the lookout on UP social media soon, because an announcement will be made. And I'm gonna hand it over to Daniel.
Is Daniel here?
Okay. Right, so Daniel wasn't here actually. So he asked me to present his slide for him. So I'm gonna go ahead and present that now. So next slide, please. So first of all, we wanna give a big thanks to the biggest sponsor for Mentor this year, which has been State Farm. So thank you so much, State Farm, for making UP Mentor possible. Next slide, please. So a little bit more about Mentor. The whole purpose of Mentor is to create a program for students to receive guidance in their careers and academic life with senior students who have been where they've been before and who can advise them on how to deal with the problems that they're facing, right? In this program, you have new and transfer students receiving advice from their mentors, and senior students are receiving guidance from professionals as well as getting newer ones. So it's a really valuable program to be in if you want to give back to the community, as well as if you want to get some connections with some big companies. Now, this year, our main mentor events have been the Navigating Your Major event, which happened Thursday, November 12th at 4 p.m. It was a great event. We had a lot of people showing up, so we're really proud of everything we were able to do this semester for Mentor. All right, and from now, we're going to hand it off to the directors of UP Shell Hacks. So Kevin, go get them.
Hi, everyone. So I'm not Kevin. I'm actually Yasmin, so I'm the co-director of Shell Hacks along with Kevin. Last minute switch up. I know we decided I'll be speaking since this is essentially my last induction as Shell Hacks director. So I just wanted to quickly talk about the program. Shell Hacks essentially is a hackathon focused program where our focus is essentially sending our FIU students to hackathon across Florida and hosting Florida's largest hackathon, Shell Hacks. We just had it this year in September. It was a really huge event. Can you go to the next slide, please? So Shell Hacks this year, actually, we beat a record of last year where we actually had 1,300 students attend, which is like a huge deal for us. We had exactly 224 projects, over 40 sponsors. We hosted a lot of workshops, 20 plus workshops. We did 10 plus activities. All of this, you know, planned as the Shell Hacks organizing team. A huge shout out to my Shell Hacks committee. They did a lot of great work with the workshops and activities. So thank you guys so much. And then we also introduced a brand new hackathon that just happened over the summer due to focus on COVID for the first year, essentially Panther Hacks. This was partnered up with President Rosenberg. So we worked together with the president's office to just bring you guys this hackathon to connect everyone over the summer. And we're looking forward to having Panther Hacks part two for next year as well. And then our events that we've had throughout the semester, other than our two hackathons, We had Shelf Week, where we hosted a Women in Tech panel, a Getting Ready for Interviews panel, workshops with Google and Twitter. We had our Shell Night to get ready for Night Hacks. So this is events that we tend to do also before hackathons. And we had our Hack Night as well for Hack GT. I just realized that Night Hacks is called Shell Night. but yeah, that was our events for this semester. And then handing it off to Adrian, Discover Director, UP Discover. Thank you.
All right. Hey, how's it going? So I'm Adrian Perez. I'm the director of UP Discover. Next slide. So about us, this has been a interesting experiment to see about how we can empower the research community at FIU. And so our purpose is to give students the power to give students the power to do the research that they want to do. All completely student driven and student led, and it's been amazing to see some of the work that they've been doing. So we've had, it's pretty rough doing research over, you know, COVID, but we've had one really amazing team. Go to the next slide. We've had John Keto Graham doing a fantastic job leading his deepfake detection team. And we're really looking forward to seeing the work that they publish next semester. They've been competing in against some of the like best teams in the world from like Facebook, and it's really exciting. So I really look forward to seeing what they finish next semester. And so yeah, thank you guys so much.
So now we'll be announcing our newest program starting in spring 2021.
So let's start with the fact that we have heard you all. From popular demand, we have decided to bring you a program that encapsulates some of the things that we felt computer science, the curriculum, has been missing for a while, and many of you guys have been wanting to see. UP Design. Next slide, please. UP Design, as the name states, is basically a program dedicated to teaching everyone about graphic design, design in user-friendly design, and most importantly, project management. You see here, the curriculum in school does cover some of these things, but we've noticed a growing trend of people asking us like, hey, how do I do this for graphic design? How do I do this for UI design? There's a demand for it, which is why we decided to build something like this. This program is not going to be led by me nor Caesar, but we will be taught and led by someone who has amazing design skills. So I hope you guys will be looking forward to it. So if any of you all are interested in UI, UX design, graphic design, project management, or just want to know about more things to computer science than coding or enhancing your projects, keep an eye out on this. Spring 2021. Have fun, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for all our program directors and our community members. And thank you for all the hard work you put out for this past semester. From the bottom of our, from our community and from the executive board, we really appreciate you guys. So here we go. So we have Code, we have Lazaro, Zach, and Zach Santana, Meg, Miguel, Infotech, Nora, Lillian, Martin, Lugansky. Thank you guys. Avance, Ignite, SparkDev, all these members. Thank you guys so much for helping out for during this hard time for this past semester. And yes, so if you guys are interested in becoming a committee for one of our programs, one of us just announced, or like our past slides, feel free to apply to UP committee and yeah, get a part of our committee. And I also want to thank our executive board. We couldn't have done this without you. So everyone who just basically presented everyone, our logistics, our communications, like everyone. Thank you guys so much. That's and sweet. Then.
Would you be cool if I presented this part? I love this
part. Oh, sorry.
All right, great. Let's do this. Okay, so first off, yeah, so just that right there on that slide, you see our e-board. And honestly, we couldn't be where we are right now if it weren't for the amazing efforts of all of our e-board members. So if we can go to the next slide, please, we are going to recognize every single one of them by name. All right. So first off, you got me, the president, of course, I'm right here. We have our executive vice president, Raul Feife. And then we also have our director of membership, Catherine Yee, our associate director of membership, Titin Deshi Mahaka. You have our director of finance, Hoiling Ung. our Director of Logistics, Ivan Reyes. You have our Director of Marketing, Shauna Sitt, Director of Communications, Adriana Sandino, Director of Social and Digital Media, Hoi Ung, Associate Director, Janae Fernandez. You have our Director of Industry Relations, Raheem Idris. You have our Makerspace Manager, Oscar Barbosa. Our historian is Justin Venegas, and our CSO representative is Christoph Little. Special thanks to our SGE representative, Christopher Lugo, for being one of the most amazing senators we've ever had. And then our program directors are in order. The Director of UP Code is DeJuan Harris. Director of UP Make is Charles King. UP Infotech is Nathan Pavon. UP Advance is Gabriela Gutierrez. Director of UPE Ignite is Diana Barrero. UPE SparkDev is Yusuf Abdusalam. Their UPE mentor is Daniel Saleh. Our co-directors of UPE Shell Hacks are Yasmin Abdravo and Kevin Osada. Our director of UPE Discover is Adrian Perez. And our faculty advisor for the umpteenth year in a row is Dr. Peter Clark. So thank you guys all so much. I think you all deserve a huge round of applause for everything we've been able to do this year. Thank you guys so much. Okay, and now is the part where we get to install our 2021 executive board. I am so excited for these guys. So next slide here. Our upcoming 2021 president is going to be Adriana Sandino, with the upcoming vice president being Raul Fife again. Thank you so much, Raul. Our incoming director of communications is Mohammed Qureshi. Our incoming director of membership is Jalen Vega. Director of finance will be Hoi Ling Ong once again. Our director of logistics will be Ivan Reyes once again. Co-directors of marketing next year will be Anna Organvidas and Luis Solozano. The co-directors of social and digital media will be Danai Fernandez and Karen Morales. Our co-directors of industry relations will be Jose Hernandez and Richard Garcia. The director of technology will be DeJuan Harris. Our director of publications will be Liana Luis Araza. Our CSO representative will be Justin Venegas. And our co-SDR representatives will be Christopher Lugo and Eduardo Gonzalez Rojas. So thank you guys so much. And of course, we also have next year's program directors as well. So taking up the mantle on UPE Code will be Zachary Santana. UPE Make will be continued by Miguel De Jesus. UPE Infotech will be led by Lillian Ash. Director of UPE Advanced next year will be Joseph Boylan. Our director of UPE Ignite next year will be Nicholas Gonzalez. Next year, SparkDev will be led by Yusuf Abdulsalam once again. So thank you, Yusuf. Our director of UPE Mentor next year will be Daniel Saleh. Our co-directors next year for UPE Shell Hacks will be Kevin Osala and Nicholas D'Souza. And finally, next year's director of UPE Design will be Kimberly Cruz. So that's the roster for next year. I'm so excited to see what you guys are going to be able to accomplish. And until then, we have now the main event of the night. We have our induction ceremony. So Catherine, you want to get us started?
Okay, cool. So everyone who's here, who to be inducted, welcome. Congratulations for being selected for becoming a UPE national member. So yeah, we're gonna get started. We're gonna start with the UPE ceremony of initiation. So basically what our induction is for members who have excelled academically, who went out and beyond to have a great GPA, have more than 45 plus credits, and who is a CS or IT major. So we have faculty staff who have contributed to the Honor Society, and we have an invitation from, basically you have to get an invitation from SCIS, and you will be receiving our certificate and pin, which I'll be emailing you guys later after this induction about when to meet up and pick up those things and for spring semester. So now we're gonna start our fall 2020 induction. So we could start the script now.
Okay. So members of Upsilon Pi Epsilon for 2020, let us begin our second online induction ceremony of the UPE chapter at FIU, okay? So Epsilon, will you please present the candidates?
Okay, Epsilon, I have the honor and pleasure of presenting the following candidates for initiation as honorary members of Epsilon Pi Epsilon. We have Marcos Edgar. I'm so sorry if I mess up your name. I don't mean it. Bilal Ali, Aaron Alvarez, Diana Andrea, Jean David Antoine, Sasha Arthurs, Kobe Baptiste, Daniel Bartolini, Josue Batista, Edgar Bermudez, Emily Boyle, Alexander Barn, Carla Canton, Carmen Carpio, Jeffrey Contreras, Jesus Domingo, Gamaliel Dersin, Stefan Dunn, Antonio Francesny, Alexander Garcia, Louis A. Gill, Marcelo Gonzalez, Priscilla Gonzalez, and Doni Gordestiza, Trevor Graham, Alberto Granda, Melissa Grandoit, Gabriela Gutierrez, Mohamed Hamid, Andy Hernandez, Kevin Lang, Miguel Herrera, Christopher Hinchy, John Hoover, Catherine Elisaz, Jocelyn Jaron, Lucas Johnson, Michael Johnson, Tarek Kazan, Monica Lal, Roca Michelle, Domingo Leo, Bill Lisa, David Lofgren, Christian Lopez, Martin Mako, Joel Marshall, Pablo Mercado, Ryan Mitchell, Lizzie Montoya, Eduardo Morales, Ronaldo Morales, Rara Morel, Miguel Muscatello, Shidi Beer, Otunai, Yasel Pena, Kevin Perdomo, Daniel Perez, Raheem Perkins, Xavier Ponce de Leon, Sheen Quinn, Sean Quinn, Mohamed Qureshi, Diego Rivada, Jonathan Rivera, Vanessa Rivera, Brian Rodriguez, Javelis Rios, Steven Ristales, Daniel Solid, Tyler Salzberg, Armando Sanchez, Miguel Saravia, Kieran Singh, Marjorie Ann Singh, Trinity Sakaro, Zaisal Philip, yeah, Mazar, Jonathan Bomoka, Benny Wu. So, those are our, just let me go back, my bad. Yeah. So we are happy to have you among us. Please be seated and observe our ceremony of initiation. Okay, so Upsilon, I present these candidates for initiation as active student members in the FIU chapter of Upsilon Pi Upsilon. Please remain standing as your names are called. I read you guys.
Okay, have they fulfilled all the requirements for their initiation?
They have. The candidates will be seated. We have heard by what you name you are own. Now let us consider by what traits you are own. Scholarship, leadership, ethicality, and widespread interest. It is because you possess these and many other desirable traits that you are here at this moment. UP extends you a warm welcome. Pi will now tell you the history and some of the ideals of our organization.
It is customary and appropriate that people unite with common bonds of interest. To display these bonds, characteristic symbols are used as identification. To the world, the symbols represent a society with particular goals and interests. However, to the membership, the symbols have more significant meaning, since they represent the unique association of the members with their society. So it is with Epsilon Pi Epsilon. Three historical symbols in the computing and information disciplines are the zero, the one, and the abacus. The zero and the one make the binary character set. The circle form of the zero is a symbolic of the encompassing nature of the computing and information disciplines. Enclosed within the circle are the aspects, attributes, and activities related to this field, as well as some facet from almost every discipline of culture. The one signifies the unity of purpose of Epsilon Pi Epsilon, the united effort to promote the field and its contributions. In the similar nature, the one characterizes the individual effort each member of Epsilon Pi Epsilon has made. The one is a positive symbol of truth, integrity, and maturity that are basic to the strength of Epsilon Pi Epsilon. Computing and information disciplines are relatively young disciplines and first recognized in the mid-20th century. The heritage of computing, however, stems to the origins of humanity. The abacus, the earliest and most used calculating device, symbolizes this heritage. The members of Epsilon Pi Epsilon pledge to respect the contributions previously made and to build upon that foundation. Pride in our heritage is self-evident in the great advances made in the computing and information disciplines. The emblem of Epsilon Pi Epsilon takes the general form of a key. The key represents the entry to our professional association within which individual limitations can be overcome. This access also includes the responsibility to promote the goals of the society. The manner in which you view and use this key may determine how many gates of opportunity will be open to you. The binary digits of the key represent the number 1967, the year of our founding. Also, the Greek characters spanning across the key identify the society to the world as Epsilon Pi Epsilon. Upsilon is the first letter for the Greek word computer. Pi is the first letter for information. And Epsilon is the first letter for science. The first chapter of Upsilon Pi Epsilon had many discussions held by the original group of six students. It was chartered and recognized on January 10th of 1967 at Texas A&M University.
Okay, the candidates for membership will now raise their right hand and repeat this pledge after me. Please unmute your mics for this. Let's make sure they can, please. Make sure they have the permission. Okay, so I, state your name.
I, Muhammad Quraish.
Macho.
Macho.
Having heard and understood.
Having heard and understood.
The purposes and tenets of Upsilon Pi Epsilon.
The purposes and tenets of Upsilon Pi Epsilon.
Do solemnly pledge to respect and promote the aims and ideals of the society.
The aims and ideals of the society.
All right. Thank you for that. I will repeat the pledge you have all just taken. I, having heard and understood the purposes and tenets of Upsilon Pi Epsilon, do solemnly pledge always to respect and promote the aims and ideals of the society. With this pledge, you have become one of us, a member of UPE. Remember, your lives and your acts will bear witness to the honor of the computing and information professions. One thing yet remains to be done. Your names must be entered in our chapter book to confirm the pledge you have just taken. So unfortunately, we don't have this book with us, but when we go back to in-campus learning, we will be noting your names on the book right here with us. So thank you all so much. Epsilon, have all the new members had their names taken down to be entered in our chapter book?
Yes, they have.
Then let the book be closed.
It is closed.
All right. Thank you guys so much. I welcome our members to full membership in Upsilon Pi Epsilon. As the book is closed and contains within it the names of those who are the honored members of the society, so let our minds close upon and contain the truths, ideals, and aspirations we have heard. However, as the book may always be open to receive the names of new worthy members, so let our minds always be receptive to new truths and great understandings. Members of Upsilon Pi Epsilon, we have completed the second online initiation ceremony of the UPE chapter at FIU. Thank you guys so much. It is our custom, of course, that each active member hang out in the Discord and welcome each other active new member after the ceremony. So I invite you guys to join us there in our voice channel after the ceremony. All right, thank you so much. Keep it going.
Congrats, awesome. Right.
Congratulations, everyone. Just a nice clap for everybody.
Yeah. Awesome.
Okay. So back to the faculty inductees slide, please.
Yes.
Once again, we just want to thank all the faculty inductees over the years that have made UP possible in one way or another. They are, in order, Dr. Peter Clark, Dr. Ram Iyengar. I'm so sorry if one of these people is a doctor and I forget to say doctor, so just forgive me for there. Carlos Cabrera, Deborah Davis, Christy Charters, Stephen Lewis, Mario Erasso, Tiana Solis, Miriam Hurl, and Catherine Hernandez. Thank you all so much for all the help you've given to UP throughout the years, and we appreciate everything you've done. Okay, so now finally we have the award ceremony. First, we're going to have each of the programs giving their respective awards to their program members. And then finally, we're going to be having general awards for all the UPE members. So first off, we're going to start with UPE Codes Awards. So Dahuan, if you'd like to start, don't go to the next slide, please. Not yet.
Okay. So hey, everyone. I'm back again. And I have two awards. I have an award for Best Code Cohort General Member. The code cohort was a unique program, but one person did definitely stand out among them. And you can go to the next slide now.
Catherine, you can go. There you go.
Hi, Brian Pineda. I'm sorry if I mispronounced your name. I don't know if you are here, but yeah, this person attended all the events, was definitely very active in the Discord, and always asked questions. And now for my second award, it is the Outstanding Code Committee Member, Zachary Santana. He's actually going to be our next Director of Code. So everyone go ahead and give him a round of applause. And yeah.
All All right, next up, we're going to be having the awards for UPE Make. So Charles, you want to take it away from here?
Yeah. So throughout the semester with UPE Make and all the workshops that we had, as well as on the Discord, these two members are going to be awarded the Outstanding Make Member Award. They were always very involved, always went to all the workshops, participated, talked in the chat, as well as on the Discord. So the first Outstanding Make Member Award is going to go to Maria Rivera. So you could go to the next slide. And then also the second award for Outstanding Make Member is going to go to Brian Pineda. And then after that, we also have Outstanding Committee Member Award. This committee member of mine has been there through everything. Super, super helpful guy. He's also going to be the next make the director. So give it up for Miguel De Jesus. And that's going to be all the words for UP Make. Thank you, guys.
So now we have UP Infotech. So if Nathan could present his awards.
Yep. So I have two awards to give out, one for the Outstanding Infotech member and the next award being the Outstanding Committee member. So for the Outstanding Infotech member, they have been very engaged with all of our workshops. I was actually surprised at how frequently they attended them as well, and how much they were engaged as well, especially with like interacting with us. So I present that award to go. Alec Joseph. So congrats, man. You earned it. Done really, really good for the engagement in the program as well. So I appreciate that a lot. Thank you. So the next award goes to one of our committee members. Now, this person has been very, very valuable to the program. And we also interact outside of the program as well pretty often. So I consider them pretty close in that regard. And I appreciate all of the work that they've done for our program. And that award goes to Naor Vidal. So thank you, man. Like, I really appreciate all the work that you've done for the program. It's been really awesome having you here at Infotech. So, yeah.
Awesome. So... if Gabby, could you award your awardees?
Hello. So I only had one award, but I did want to say, like, for my committee, like, they really got me through a lot of this semester and even the previous semester, and I wanted to thank all of them. As far as the UP Advanced members, I want to thank all of you guys for attending the workshops, for everything, like, all the engagement that you guys have, especially for how crazy everything has been. So I decided to just have kind of just one award for kind of the Outstanding Advanced Member Award. And it goes to Kyle Pulido. I'm sorry if I butchered that. You've been really like engaged in the Discord and you've been attending a lot of the advanced events. And I really appreciate just the hard work they've been putting in and the dedication. This goes for all other advanced members too, but you really kept the Discord going. So thank you for that.
And now we have UP Ignite, which should be Diana.
Hi, everybody. Thank you for being here today. I want to thank you, all the members that were part of the Ignite program this semester, for all your dedication, not missing any meetings, because we didn't have anybody miss the meetings. We have perfect attendance this semester. So thank you all for, pushing through with me and, you know, being patient whenever the program wasn't doing so great at the beginning of the semester, but you all kept going and you all had hopes and we were able to do it. I have two awards for this ceremony that I'm gonna be giving out. The first one is going to be for the outstanding member, which is, I believe it's Ricardo Casimiles. Thank you for all your hard work and dedication. You were always at the meetings supporting me. Thank you so much for everything you did this semester. And then for outstanding committee member, The award goes to Nicholas Gonzalez. He is also going to be the next UP Ignite director. Thank you for your hard work and for always being there for me whenever I needed anything throughout this semester and our previous semester.
Thank you. So now we have UP Sparktiv.
Hello, everyone, again. So for SparkDev, we will be awarding four different members, and the awards are going to be for Outstanding Committee Member, Outstanding Team Leader, Outstanding Team Co-Leader, and also Outstanding SparkDev Member. First of all, before we dive into the awardees, I want to congratulate every single SparkDev member because the projects that these semesters SparkDev cohort made were amazing. We're really looking forward to either continue with those same projects or keep expanding our knowledge by discovering new projects and new ideas. So drum rolls, please. So for Outstanding Team Member, we want to congratulate Kevin Zhang. Sorry if I'm mispronouncing your name correctly. So Kevin was an amazing member. He was also part of not only one, but two teams in SparkDev. So his commitment really came into fruition. Next slide. We want to congratulate as well Nicole Mei Chang for being an outstanding co-lead, always being in every team meeting, always supporting the team and the whole program as well. Next slide. Oh, and let's congratulate as well our outstanding team leader, Felipe Arce, leader of the Underline with Microsoft team. And finally, for outstanding committee member, let's congratulate Jose Hernandez, and also by being selected as a new UP board member for the next year. Congratulations again to everyone, and yeah, have a good evening.
Now I'm gonna give it to you all to UP mentor.
All right. Hey guys, so I'm here. So I'd like to start to say thank you to all the mentors and mentees. I know that this year has been kind of rough with everything being virtual, but thank you for pulling through. I do have two awards to give to both a mentor and a mentee who went above and beyond with their one-on-ones with their mentees. You go next slide. So for an outstanding mentee, it would be Keiki Sid. She did phenomenal gathering all the information that her mentor gave her with all the details. And then for mentor, based upon all the feedback we got from other mentees, I'm proud to give an outstanding member to Ivan Reyes and Hulong Yung. They went above and beyond from all the feedback and everything that they did for the mentee. So thank you so much, guys. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Yes.
Okay, so then next up we have UP Shell Hacks' awards. Yasmin, are you gonna present this one again, or is it gonna be Kevin?
Hey guys, so my name is Yasmin Abdrago. No, it's not. Adrian. Hey guys, my name is Kevin. I am the other director for UP Shell Hacks, and I am also one of the incoming co-directors for UP Shell Hacks. So we have one award, which is our outstanding committee member. It'd be really awkward to try to pick a member out of like 1,300 people for Shell Hacks, so we just didn't think it was worth it. And this award was really hard because we had, as you saw earlier, a big committee, and also pretty much every single one of our members did just outstanding. You know, it was a really rough adjustment period for us dealing with the first time that we were doing Shell Hacks online. But honestly, the committee all pulled through. But, you know, we thought that everybody stood up, but, you know, one person stood up just a little bit more. So without further ado, it is the VP himself, Mr. Raul Feife. Raul honestly just worked from the beginning of his involvement all the way to the end. He was just going out of his way to just help out in every way that he could. And, you know, he really killed it. So, you know, thank you so much, Raul. And it's, you know, it feels weird having you above me technically, but, you know, we'll see how this goes. I'm just kidding. Just kidding, guys. I love Raul. I actually got him into UP, so I'm very proud of him. And that is it for us.
Now we have UP Discovered. Yep.
Okay, awesome. Great. So I have two awards I'd like to give. So I have one for, well, our outstanding team lead for the AI team. Go to the next slide. Real quick. Next slide. Oh, okay. Sorry. So first is the outstanding team member. Okay, we could do the commit.
Sorry, there's a delay. So,
yeah, team member first. So this is for, no, it's totally cool. So this is for Hermes Bonilla. So this guy, everyone on the team is amazing. And I'd like to give a special commendation to Hermes. So he is not only a prominent member in the team and has pushed a lot forward, but Hermes is also a dual enrolled high schooler. So he's actually technically a high schooler and dealing with some of the hardest material that you can deal with in computer science. This kid is insane, and he's gonna do amazing things like he has been doing with the deep fake detection team. He's amazing. Everyone on the team is, but we felt like Hermes deserved a special shout out for tonight. And then the next slide, sorry about the order. So this is for John Keto Graham. He is the only team lead, but John has been doing so much this semester. Not only does he have a full workload for class, he also has a job with NVIDIA as an internship. So not only has he been dealing with NVIDIA, full schoolwork, John has also been working with the Discover team and really doing a fantastic job leading them, guiding them in the ways of AI and deep learning. And it's impressive to see him work. And so, you know, I'm very glad to have him as a team lead and very glad to have Hermes and the rest of the team. They're all phenomenal. So yeah, those are the two commendations I'd like to give. Thank you guys so much.
All right. And then next up for the membership awards, I'm going to be going at 10 presenting these on my own machine. So if you can let me share my screen from here.
Yes, sir.
All right. There. Okay, perfect. So you guys see this? Okay, cool. So first off, let's talk about the top 10 participants through the year of people who have attended our events, okay? In the beginning of the semester, we stated that we were going to be tallying up points for all the people that attend our events, certain points for certain events. And today we're going to be presenting the top 10 of all the people that attended our events. They are, in order, from first place to last place, first to 10th, the person who attended the most of our events was Jeffrey Contreras. And then after him, in order, are Michael Johnson, Alec Joseph, Sajal Natuhari, Gonzalo Mera, Jose Hernandez, Taylor Gross, Mohamed Qureshi, Francisco Quiroz, and Bjorn Hare. So thank you guys so much for patronizing all of our events, basically. And I appreciate you guys for showing up and really making the community lively, you know? So after this, a little bit of a drum roll, please, because we have our outstanding member of the semester, and he's kind of been sweeping today, I'm not going to lie, but he is Jose Hernandez. So thank you so much, Jose, for being there. You've been such a fixture this entire semester. And honestly, we don't know where we'd be right now without you there, like keeping the Discord lively and all that. So thank you so much, Jose. Now, after the outstanding member, we also have three particularly helpful members that have really shined throughout the semester and really shown what UP's community can be like. So the first one of these is Samuel Morris. So I don't know if Sam's here right now, but he's been a fixture in the community for as long as anyone can think. He's pretty much the guy when it comes to for hardware. So thank you, Sam, so much for being in the community, and we appreciate you so much. Next up, second, we have Maria Rivera. So thank you so much, Maria, as well, for being there in the community. You have been such a fixture, and we appreciate you a lot. And then lastly, we have Andres Rojas. So thank you guys so much for being there. You guys have been so active during this semester. Pretty much every time we look at the chat, we'd see you guys saying something, and we're glad to have people like you in this club. Okay, so now here's a bit of a drum roll. At the end of the year, we usually like to award the executive board member that has really stood out and done above and beyond for making sure that everything that needs to get done gets done, but also keeping morale high and making sure people see that it's inspiring to get work done, okay? So this year, our outstanding executive board member is Adriana Sandino. So thank you so much, Adriana. Let's just give her a huge clap here. You know, thank you so much, Adriana. She's going to be president next year as well. So that's crazy. Can you believe that? We're so proud of you, Adriana. Thank you. Okay, so we were only going to do one outstanding executive board member, but like the thing is, sometimes you'll just have multiple people that are just shining and are absolutely incredible and have really carried the organization for as long as they have. So we are actually giving one other award to a particularly outstanding executive board member, one that's been there basically from the beginning, from longer than all of us have, honestly. She's just been an absolute gem to work with. She's been amazing. She's been the morale of UP basically for longer than I've been here. And she is Shauna Sitt. So thank you so much, Shauna. And for you, we don't have a title, but we do have a custom made trophy. And it looks like this. So here we go. I'm hoping you guys can see that. And we made this just for you because you've been there throughout 3 years of UP marketing. You've been there to basically come up with the theme every single year and come up with new things. So we thought it'd be cool to give you a trophy that shows exactly what kind of stuff you've contributed throughout all of your years of service. So thank you so much, Shauna. We know it's your last year with us. We wish you could be here longer, but we appreciate everything you've done. So thank you so much, Shauna. Okay, so some closing remarks here. First off, we want to give a huge thanks to, of course, our executive board, but also our committee members of all of our programs, our members, our sponsors, our partners, our faculty, our staff, and our families. I love you, Mom. But that's pretty much it. So thank you guys so much for attending our second initiation induction fall ceremony of the online year. And we're looking forward to seeing you guys next year.
Hey, Matt, may I say a few words from the advisor?
Of course you may, Dr. Clark. Thank you. Go ahead.
Yes. So I would like to thank Catherine and Matt for organizing this induction ceremony. I think they did a great job. Thanks to the e-board and all the directors of the various programs. This was another outstanding year for UPE amid the many challenges with the COVID-19 virus. Congrats to the new members and the awardees. I would like to congratulate Matt and Ivan for winning the UPE National Award with some cash that I'm sure they'll use in their future endeavors. So thank you guys very much. Thanks to the new e-board members, directors and program directors. You guys do a phenomenal job. UPE is now recognized by the university, including the FIU president. I've been at several town hall meetings and college meetings where he singled out UPE as outstanding student chapter. So I think you guys are doing a great job. And again, with my long years in UPE, we've gone from holding our induction in now case 243 to actually being virtually with 83 members. So this has really grown. Congratulations to the Shell Hacks organizers, Yasmin and Kevin. Again, this has brought tremendous recognition to FIU beyond, I guess, your wildest dreams. And the FIU administration has really acknowledged and understand the contribution UPE and Shell Hacks has made. Congratulations to UPE Ignite for winning a State Farm grant for over $24,000. I would like to specifically thank Diana for all her hard work in the summer and making sure we got the grant written correctly. So thank you for that. This is really a great effort. So we have some money for Ignite, and I'm sure the new Ignite director will tell the members more about it. And I would like to say a special thanks to the UPE past presidents for their continued work with UPE, specifically Cesar Villa, who will not seem to leave UPE, but he contributes every year. He does a tremendous job. Caesar, UPE is now in your blood. You could always come back and do a graduate degree at FIU if you want to be close. So thank you. And I also like to thank Chris. I know Chris also continued to contribute. So from me as the advisor, I would like to say thanks to everyone for a phenomenal year and overcoming all of the obstacles that were placed in your way this year. So thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Clark. And thank you all for coming tonight. So this is the end of the induction ceremony, and this is the end of UPE's official events for the semester. But it doesn't have to be the end of the night. So after this, we're going to be going to our Discord channel to just hang out and talk for a little bit. You're all invited. It'll be a little bit of an after party. So we'll see you all there. Thank you guys so much for coming once again tonight. And we appreciate you guys so much. Thank you. Okay.
And congrats, bye, graduates.
Congratulations, everyone. All right. See you guys.
See you guys.